All right, so a lot of you people have been asking one simple question over the last couple of my live streams, let it be even the personal messages that you send me on LinkedIn. And I wanted to answer this question in much more detailed sense. So in this video, I'm going to be discussing with you guys how much is a Flutter job going to pay in real term. And we're going to compare it to with one of the most popular programming languages in the world, which is Python. So I'm going to be taking this complete video in a most data-driven way as possible. And I'm not going to be making any kind of a predictions or anything of that sort here. Just data-driven, we're going to completely depend upon Google here. And you're going to do this complete to exercise to depend and get the knowledge that you want to as to what really does a Flutter job going to pay. So if you are going to making a very good decision, like you are actually depending upon this decision, this video is going to be really helpful for you guys. And you make sure to watch it till the end of this video, because I've got a lot of information. It's not just about this one simple answer. I'm going to be giving you a lot of different information as well as making you guys understand the growth path and also the salary path that you can take if you're going to consider as a Flutter job in your a complete full-time work. So that's why I'm going to be doing this video. Let's get this video started. Alright, so the first thing that I want to discuss with you guys is to just look at this one simple graph. So what you're going to do is you're going to do a simple exercise here. First thing you're going to do is go into Google, type this line. We're going to type Python developer jobs, and we're going to just take it in India first example. As you can see, there are a lot of applications, there are a lot of jobs that are available in terms of Python programming. And I'm just going to click into one of the example here, and it says that it's going to give me a range of salary that it's going to give me. So I'm going to be looking for the next search term, which is Python developer jobs in India salary. So if you put that here, you can see that the starting salary for an Indian developer, as a junior developer, is anywhere from 28 to 32,000 per month, which is in INR, and it's going to be just like this junior developer. If you are actually good at Python programming, let's say that you have 1 year experience, 2 year experience, you can see that the price range goes a little bit up, and you can even see an upward curve to up to 45 to 50,000 INR in a good decent company. Now let's do the same exercise for United States as well. This is because there's a couple of reasons. All of Indians are looking to always look for something on site in terms of like looking for a job that is in United States, because a lot of you people have the dream of going to United States or United Kingdom, where you can work and also earn in dollars and pounds. So let's do the same exercise in United States now. That you can put into that into example. As you can see that it's going to take you in terms of $88,000 per annum as the base pay for a junior developer. So if you're living in Silicon Valley, this will convert to roughly around $8,000 to $8,500 per month, which is actually a good amount to live if you ask me in Silicon Valley, as such, which is California. And you can actually go inside and you also see that the price range, obviously because of the states that you're going to offer, get the job offer and all of that sort. So anyway, the base thing that we're going to look at is the United States, which is going to be around anywhere from $75,000 per annum, and it could touch upwards of $80,000, even $90,000 per annum, depending on where you get the job. So that's the graph for us now. So why did we even do this work here? So the important thing that we are going to be doing in this video is to compare our language of choice, which is actually, for me, it's Python, because I love Python so much. And it could be Java for you, JavaScript for you, or whatever you're confused with. Now let's do the same exercise for your programming language as well. And you can see that this is going to be the base pay. That means that you're going to be paid this much when you complete like your understanding of JavaScript or Java or Python. So that's going to be the base pay. Now the next thing that you have to do is go and understand the top pay, like what is going to be the best offer that I'm going to be given if I'm going to be a good Python or Java or JavaScript developer. I'm going to be doing the same exercise again in India, and as you can see that you are given an offer of up to 12 lakh per annum, which is in Indian rupees, which is upwards of 1 lakh per month in Indian rupee salary. So that's, for example, if you're really good senior Python developer, which is actually a good thing. Now do the same exercise again with United States. You can see that you're given a salary of upwards of $150,000 per annum, which is roughly around $12,500 per month, which is a good, great amount if you're actually a very good senior Python developer. So that's going to be the first exercise. Now we're going to complete this exercise, and we have done this range in order to understand how much is going to be the salary that's going to be given to me, and you are done with that. Now apply the same in Flutter, and I did apply the same with Flutter, and I typed been first in this example as a Flutter jobs around me or Flutter jobs in India. As soon as I type, there aren't a lot of jobs that are actually Flutter oriented. There are some which is actually cross platform where they're asking for a React Native as well as a Flutter knowledge, and that's okay. It's okay sign. I'm not going to be saying that's the best sign out there, but it's okay sign. Now next thing that you're going to do is how much is the pay out there for me? And as you can see that there are some job offers which entitle you to know more than just Flutter and Dart. They also want you to know about React Native. They also want you to know about JavaScript, and only then they're going to be giving you an offer of maybe 25 to 28,000, even though you are actually going to be a Flutter developer. So that's going to be the base pay. So that's starting pay. Do the same exercise with the United States again, and I was just a little bit of in the shock to see that there aren't a lot of Flutter as a jobs available in the United States in the first place. And even though there are some available, most of them are for startups only, all of these small business types that they want to do some rapid prototyping stuff. And there aren't a lot of application jobs as such. There are some are a freelance kind of a work. There aren't really a full-time work that you can depend upon for your full-time income. So it also is going to be in the range of $50,000 per annum, which is roughly around $4,000 to $4,500 per month. I mean, can you live with that amount in a Silicon Valley? I don't really think so. So that's going to be the range for Flutter. So this is a simple exercise. You have understood the range of money that you're going to get. You can get anywhere from 25,000 in Indian rupees, and upwards, if you even see an upwards, it's going to be upwards of 35,000 to 40,000 if you are considered as a good senior developer in Flutter. There isn't really something to call senior here because it's a really new language. So the senior here would mean that you need to have additional understanding of all the other stuff, technologies as well. So that's going to be the range of pay that you're going to look at if you are actually in the range. I mean, if you're looking for a Flutter job in India at the moment. So this is the first step. You've not completed this video yet. This is the first step because I've got another step, couple of more steps to actually lay down what is important. So next step that you're going to look at is actually to look what exactly is going to be my growth path. That's what I'm going to see, right? Alright, now that you have looked into the range of salaries that's being offered, the next is going to be the growth path that you want to fix. Now, if you take an example of Python, which is the most wanted programming language, you could see that the growth path is a very big curve. You're paid in lower range of 30,000 to 35,000 per month, and you could reach an upward of even 1 lakh or even up to 2 lakhs if you're actually working in a really good fan company, meaning the top 4 companies in the world. So if you're working for them, you would even get upwards of 2 lakh per month as your salary, which is roughly 25 lakh LPA as your package, which is huge amount if you ask me in India. You could do the same exercise again with United States. As you can see, the growth path is really big, vast. You can start from $88,000 to $90,000 per annum and reach upwards of $150,000 per annum in just your salary, and you would even touch another $100,000 in stock options and all of that stuff. And that's short if you're actually going to be looking at the top 4 companies in the world. So the growth path is really vast. I mean, you could start as a junior Python developer and you could reach the top, and it's obviously up to your standard, like how fast you're grasping all this stuff. It could take anywhere from 5 to 7 years and you could reach the top in just that amount of time. But can you do the same with Flutter? I mean, let's be real and practical here and just take Flutter for example and see what is the growth path that I'm looking at. I mean, I'm looking at a starting salary of 28,000, and I could grow to 40,000 if I understand the additional technologies associated with cross-platform development, React Native, JavaScript. I still need to learn all of that, and if I learn all of that, I'm going to be considered still as a Flutter developer, and I'm going to be given a top salary of 40,000 INR per month, and it could roughly convert, if you can take United States for example, you'll be given around 4,000 to 4,500 dollar per month in terms of a salary asset. So is this the growth path that you want to take? I mean, if you are actually really comfortable with that growth path, I mean, you're very happy with the 40,000 INR per month salary, then that should not be a matter for you. You could still learn a lot of additional technologies and start growing from there, but this is going to be the path that Flutter is going to give you, and that is a completely different spectrum. Is the most wanted programming languages like Java, JavaScript, Python, C#, .NET, all of them giving a completely different route. So it's up to you to decide what route you want to take. Now that I've seen what's the growth path that you wanted to point A to point B, how long is it going to take? Next up is how easy it is going to be to land in point A in the first place. Meaning that how easy it is going to be to land a developer job in Flutter as well as Python. So that's what I'm going to be seeing right now. All right, so the last point that I want to discuss in brief here again is that to discuss with you guys how easy it is to go and reach the point A, meaning that how easy it is going to be to land a job in Python as well as Flutter. Now, as you know that as you start growing in your field and as you also start growing in terms of a package, it is also relatively difficult to land into that package in the first place. So are there a lot of Python developers? Definitely there are. I mean, you could see just amount of Python programmers in the world. It could be upwards of, you know, the 50% of the developer population would call themselves as a Python developer. Well, is the same with Flutter again? I mean, it's not. It would roughly be around 1% or the 2% of the people, developer population, calling them as Flutter developers. So that's going to be the competition that you're going to look at. So if you're going to take up a course, let's assume that you're going to take up a Python developer course, and it's going to be mostly in terms of a bootcamp type of a course, or it could be even a theoretical type of a course, and you're completing this course, which is taking you anywhere from 5 to 6 months to complete. By the end of the 6 months, how easy is it going to be to land a Python developer job? I mean, if you have a really good portfolio, if you have put up a resume in the first place, and you also have actually a lot of real-time examples that you can show, you could get a good intern, or you could even get a startup like a junior developer job. Maybe I would say with complete possibility of upwards of 85 to 90%, because since the demand is so high for example, let's assume that Python demand is so high, people are still always in lookout for a junior developer. Now do the same example, or just do the same thing with Google again, just type it in Google. How easy or how in the first place is going to be to learn your Flutter / Dart incomplete? So first thing you can do is to go and look at for a developer tutorial, or maybe you could go for a course, and you're going to pay $200 or $300 for this Flutter / Dart course. By the end of this course, you have a certificate and you also have a good resume to put up. And also how easy it is going to be for companies to pick up less important, or they would consider having one or two cross-platform developers in the team of 20. Well, when the demand is that low, people are still going to compete for that, and it's also going to be a little bit difficult to land a Flutter / Python, means Flutter / Dart developer job right out of the bat. I mean, the demand is low and people are also not look out in converting that process. Like say for example, is there any really strong Flutter / developer course out there? I mean, I haven't seen anything Udemy or EDX or Coursera, or for example even Skillshare. That isn't really a strong course to do that. And on the second place, are there any good certificate courses that you can take? I mean, there aren't any again. Are there any standard courses? For example, Java has an Oracle developer job, I mean developer certificate, and Python also has a lot of standard developer certificates. There aren't any as such for Flutter and Dart. So there are Flutter GDEs or Dart GDEs, which is actually really difficult to get, in terms of meaning that you have to contribute so much to the society and the community of Flutter developers, and only then you'll be landing that. So that's going to be the two spectrums that you're looking at, and how easy it is going to be land right out of the bat. If you're completing a course, or if you competing like a boot camp, will it be possible to land? I mean, it's really not sure at this point, because the demand is so low and also people aren't converting faster. So that means that there aren't really going to be a lot of people looking to hire a cross-platform developer in their team. So hopefully I understand that you guys get a complete understanding of how easy it is, or how difficult it is, or how much is the Flutter really going to pay you in terms of a job, and in terms of salary, and in terms of job security again. And that's what we did see in this complete video. I took you through three important steps to compare whatever language you want to compare with. There is one question that one person asked in my previous live stream, as I am actually into JavaScript and also into Flutter, but my country does not have a lot of Flutter Dart developer jobs at all. But rather they have a lot of JavaScript jobs, and should I take JavaScript or should I go into Flutter? And my answer was, it's going to be obviously JavaScript, because if your country is offering JavaScript, the demand is there for JavaScript. Why not learn it and just get into first and take your Flutter as a hobby programming language? That's going to be my advice for anybody who's asking. I'm not in any way, being partial towards Flutter or Flutter and Dart, saying that this is the only programming language that you need to learn. Rather, it's going to be about what is good for you. So that's what I did make this video for. Hopefully you guys understood the importance. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Drop a like to this video if you like what I talked about in this video, and also subscribe to the channel, because I need subscribers. Anyway, let me know the next video, something really important and also something really important to talk about, and I'll be at your service. And let me meet you then. Until then, Bharat, peace out. Have a super awesome day.